Another year wiser. Yeah, yeah, we know. Now, where are our presents?
I'm so hasty, huh?
Oh, I mean, you two are the best parents ever. Now, can we please, maybe, please have our presents now? Please?
Okay, all right. Well, this is what your grandfather got for us. A book of all my favorite stories when I was your age. The Little Pigs, the Red Riding Hood, Goldilocks, all the classics, really.
Now, where's mine?
Well, your father and I thought you'd really like to share a much more bigger present this year, so go ahead and unwrap it.
Oh my gosh! Thank you so much, Mom and Dad! It's perfect!
Oh, wait! We have to share this? No. How am I going to be able to hide this on Crutch?
Now, your cousins are going to be coming soon, and you want to look presentable when they come.
Oh, okay, we'll get dressed.
No, we won't.
You won't? No, we won't. Why won't we?
Where are Emma and Cole's presents?
You can't get your presents until your cousins come, silly.
Fine, we'll get dressed, but they better be here when we come back. Come on, Gretchen.
Why are Hans and Gretchen always so crowded? You
well,
know,
they
even on the holidays with them all their nice presents. You think for once they can be grateful for what they have. Here. Oh, I guess you two aren't here. Now, come on.
cool.
Yeah, right.
No, really. Come look.
No, that's so stupid. Oh, forget it. I'm going to bed.
I wish I had the courage to stand up to Hans. He's always so mean and bossing me around.
Okay. repair the castle. And we'll take the tour to the castle as well. We'll get them repaired.
Good. Now for a spell. Take them inside this book to learn to be polite and wait their turn. Keep them out and let us in only until they've learned their lesson. To guide them through their journey now, magic trees, please take a bow. Through every high and every low, please show these twins where to go. Gretchen, you're gonna have to read your way through this book. Your mom's right. You might learn a thing or two.
Come on, Torres, into the castle.
What pretty hair you have, Miss Princess Patty.
Well, I thought you laughed and liked it for it.
Go get her!
No!
bossing around those pigs.
Bossy? What are you saying? You're the one who blew down their house. If I'm bossy, then you're just cruel.
What do you mean, being cruel? I have a cold. It's not my fault I have a strong sneeze. You shouldn't be bossing people around. That's just plain rude. It should be nice if you wouldn't have to make any friends, you know.
Why do I have to be nice when I can force people to be my friends?
Why would anyone want to be friends with you, nice or not?
Well, you know, I've got like hundreds of friends back home.
Don't lie, Hans. You don't have any friends back home.
Pigs, over here, quick. Come on. Okay, come on. This guy's your friend. You're better than that. He's just a bully.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry about the earlier. I'll be at your houses. I just have this nasty cold. You should be less bossy so that people will actually want to be a friend instead of being forced to.
Bossy? I'm not bossy. Take that back. I guess I could be a little nicer. But it's not like I'm even mean anyway, right?
Yes, you are, Hans. We don't want to be your friends if you were to be so mean and bossy.
You guys don't actually think that, do you?
Well, you seem pretty bossy to me. I think you should get a big, big hug.
Ew! Oh! Chunks are so gross.
You just need another hug.
Come on, Ross. We still have nowhere to stay for the night.
Well, would you like me to help?
No!
Come on, you guys are mean. I'm turning cranny on you, pigs.
What are we gonna do now?
Morgan, don't tell us it has it.
Okay, we're having fun with that, but what are we gonna do now?
Well, why don't we try reading the book? I mean, that's how the fairies always get out of here.
I guess so.
Let's see what's next in here. Once upon a time, there was Little Red from the Hood. Where are we?
We're in the forest, Beth.
Well, I told you we should turn left back.
your help.
And where are we headed?
We're headed that way. Come on, Gretchen.
Yeah. That's the way y'all just came. Look, my brain's sick, so I'm dropping off some groceries from the crib if you want to come with. Oh, I think that's a good idea. How about it, huh? Okay. Over here, G-Ma!
It's a wolf! Here we are, Cruddy. He is red.
For heaven's sake, I've been worried sick about you.
Yeah, you seem quite sick, y'all.
Cruddy, even when I feel that you're not quite well, you bring me quite the pain to my shoulder.
Oh, hush up, and don't speak to your grandmother yourself.
Sorry, Cruddy.
This is a basket of chow that Mom and Pa's bought for you. Here you go, Granny.
Oh, food! Oh, what I would do for just a little.
Hush up, kid. This is for G-Ma.
So here, Red. I'll share my food. Give the boy and his sister a bit of my bread. Here you go, Peeps.
Oh, no, thank you. I couldn't possibly.
Oh, I sure could.
How is it?
So good. Is there any more?
Don't be so greedy, Hans.
Would you care for some?
Achoo!
Jeez, that's nasty.
Oh, you just sneezed all over it. Oh, that's so gross. I guess I'll just have some of my pixie sticks.
Pixie sticks? I haven't had pixie sticks in so long. Can I have one, please, bro? Please, come on.
Yeah, my pixie sticks.
Come on, Hans. Granny shared some of her food with us. Maybe you can give everyone a pixie stick now.
No way. Nah.
Do you guys think Hans should share his pixie sticks?
Yeah.
Yeah. See, Hans, everyone thinks that you should share. I mean, sharing is caring, right?
Guess so. Fine, but I only have five. How many is enough for everyone?
Maybe we should count how many people are here to see how many pixie sticks we really need.
Rex, could you count how many people are here? You can get the kids to help.
Sure, G-Ma. Hands is true. He won't leave and share his food. Clap with me and you will see. How many people are here with go open
that book again? Seemed to get us out of the Well, tell them, Goldilocks. How many more kids pretend to be furniture in this house?
No more, sir. Really, promise. You see, there must be some misunderstanding. This is Goldilocks' house.
What?
Well, I might have told a teeny tiny little lie.
Teeny tiny? Look at this mess. Enough. I want the whole story.
Okay, sir. You see, my brother and I were walking in the woods when we came across Goldie. I mean, your house. She let us in, and things kind of got out of control, and messes were made. I'm really sorry.
Me too. I took advantage of your empty house and lied about it being my own. I'm sorry.
And what about you, sir?
Me? No, I don't know what they're talking about.
You know what? Things look better to you when you tell the truth and face up to what you've done. So.
Well.
Come on, Hans. Not that hard.
All right. I guess I contributed to some of the mess, so I'm sorry.
Well, that's a start.
What do we do now, Mama? This house is still a mess.
Not to worry, my dear. I'll just bring out my Robotron 2000.
Oh. Whoa! I used to have one of those. I didn't know it was so cool.
Indeed, it is. Now, quick, we need your help. It won't work without a song. Will you sing with me?
Clean up, everybody, everywhere. Clean up, everybody, do your share.
Again.
Clean up, everybody, everywhere. Clean up, everybody, do your share.
Okay. Yes, dude, that was me. Thank you so much for coming.
Oh, no problem. Thank you all so much for being so understanding, but my brother and I really must be going. Come on, Hans.
Oh, wait! You forgot your book!
Oh, thank you so much. Can't get any more about this. Come on. Okay. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful maiden named Cinderella.
A beautiful maiden?
Look at your hair.
could stand people as mean as that.
Yeah, neither did I, really. Anyway, now, Cinderella, now that they're gone, you can have the prince all to yourself.
We're sorry for being so mean to you.
It's okay. I forgive you. Oh, but the prince!
But I'm not ready.
Sure you are. You look great. Maybe we could just find, like, a jacket around her somewhere.
Do you guys see a jacket around here I can wear?
No.
Remembering our advice.
went through all the stories you told us about, like the three little pigs and Cinderella and Goldilocks and Little Red Riding Hood. The ones you told us about, Mom.
Okay, well, that's nice. Have dinner.
Oh, wait. Can we have a dinner, Mom, please? Pretty please?
Sure, all right.
Oh, wait, Dad. I know. What a great singer you are. Did it make you want to sing a song to end the show?
Yeah.
You guys wanted to hear John sing.
Yeah.